And we're ready to go qualifying. It'll be Powell, Tennessee's Jimmy Dalton. Powell, Tennessee's Jimmy Dalton in the two. Along with him, it'll be the Mount Carmel Missile, Sean Flannery in the custom suspension. Caspa Angus, MB Customs, Mullins, race engines powered MB Custom race car. Lap one for Jimmy Dalton, 17.018. Sean Flannery down to the line, 16.103. Sean Flannery mashes the loud pedal out of turn number two. Lap two for Jimmy Dalton to the line, improves 16.853 for Jimmy Dalton. And Sean Flannery to the line even faster, 15.873. 15.873, Sean Flannery on top of the charts. And currently to the leaderboard, we will have a $100 Fast Qualifier Award courtesy of Speedway Video Productions. And up next, it'll be the 92 car at Lansing, Tennessee. It'll be the Charlie Hopper Enterprises West End Market Garage, Jerry Septic, Hopper-powered Lightning race car. It is Matthew Hopper in the 2. And the 7 car to Seymour, Tennessee, King Machine and Welding, KCW, Scotty Evans Motorsports, Mulvane Lethal race car. It'll be Chase King in 7. Matthew Hopper, 17.755. Chase King, 16.410. He goes to second fast. In his Mulvane Lethal race car as Matthew Hopper completes lap two, 16.761. He goes to third. And Chase King to the line. He slows down on lap two, 16.457. He will stay second fast. Best lap at 16.410. It'll be London, Kentucky's Jamie Mosley, the former NASCAR nationwide competitor. In the Crossbar Electronic Cigarettes, a London Auto Sales, a Mullins Powered Lightning race car of London, Kentucky. And along with him, it'll be the Reds Muffler Shop, Wilson's Machine Shop, Race Carburetors, Winrock Photography, Smiley Powered Bandit race car to Wartburg, Tennessee. It'll be Amos Bunch in 50. Jamie Mosley, 17.119. He'll be sixth fast. Amos Bunch, 16.840 on lap number one to put him fourth fast. 16.840 for Amos Bunch. Lap two coming for both drivers. Jamie Mosley will not improve. He'll stay 17.119. And Amos Bunch slows down on lap two as well. He'll go 17.180, his best lap at 16.840 to put him fourth fast. And here comes the wild man, Wayne James out of Newport, Tennessee, in the Gary Myers Performance Race Car with Lane's Market, Old Smoky Candy Kitchen, and Steve's Heating and Air for the 7-time Volunteer Speedway Track Champion. And along with him, the Reds Muffler Shop, Wico 95.5 Bruce Bill Performance Race Car with a Blackjack Racing Engine out of Lansing, Tennessee. It'll be Dustin Dodden at 112. Wayne James, 17.302, 17.302. And Dustin Dodden at 17.823, 17.823 for Dodden. Wayne James down for lap two. Goes to fourth fast, good lap, 16.799, 16.799. And Dustin Dodden improves 17.384. It is still Sean Flannery atop the charts, looking to grab that $100 Fast Qualifier bonus courtesy of Speedway Video Productions. And we will have a check presentation on the front straightaway following qualifying. Next car on the racetrack, the Lexington Landscape, Joe Small Engine, Wall Construction, Markham Automotive, Kevin Fisher Bandit Race Car out of Elkton, Kentucky, the 2015 American Modified Series Champion, Clayton Miller in 15 along with him. Two-time Withville Raceway track champion out of Chilhowie, Virginia, it is Justin Blevins. In his Service Master MRE, Brown's Appraisal Service, Marion Tire, Shaw by Earl Race Car. Clayton Miller, second fastest after lap one, improves. He'll stay second at 16.209. 16.209, and Justin Blevins goes to fourth fast. Good lap for the 50 at 16.677. So Clayton Miller is second. And up next, it'll be the 95 card of Andrews, North Carolina, the Supercharge Energy Drink Fast Eddies Starters and Alternators. Andrews-powered Laser race car for Steve Clark. And along with him, it'll be the 36 car, Billy Palmer, Eagle-powered Warrior race car of Hardin Valley, Tennessee, with Mighty Muffler, Hardin Valley Paint Body DDT Incorporated, and Bruce Built Performance for the 36 of Billy Palmer. Steve Clark in 95 will turn the ninth fastest lap at 16.956. 16.956. Billy Palmer will be 11th fast, 17.248 for the 36 car. Next car on the racetrack, the 271. Out of Silver Point, Tennessee, it'll be Chad Crane. Chad Crane in 271. The Old Camp Whiskey Heartland Roofing Race Tennessee Series. Ron's Tire and Road Service. Cobble-powered CRC race car, and it'll be Melvin, Kentucky's Jody Puckett in the Tahiti Energy Twin Bridge Auto Parts Mullins Race Engines-powered Lightning race car for Melvin, Kentucky's Jody Puckett. Chad Crane at 17.648, 17.648. Jody Puckett goes to fourth fast after lap one at 16.531, 16.531. Good lap for Jody Puckett on lap one. Chad Crane will not improve. He will slow down. Jody Puckett on lap two slows down just a touch. He will stay fourth fast at 16.531. Next car on the racetrack out of Taylorsville, Kentucky, in the 33Z, the Valvoline Emma's Place Feed Store Kissinger's, a Red Angus KBC Graphics Dale Mears Lightning race car. That is Zach Powers. Zach Powers in 33. And out of Cookeville, Tennessee, got the win here a couple of weeks ago in the CNC Collision and Towing Mullins Sherman Enterprises. Number 29, that is Joey Cotterman. Joey Cotterman in 29. And Zach Powers, lap one at 16.902, 16.902. He will slow down on lap number two as Cotterman comes out of turn number four. And Cotterman trips the line, and Cotterman will be ninth fast, 16.850, 16.850. Puts Joey Cotterman ninth fast. Here comes Mr. Lightning, Donnie Adams, out of London, Kentucky, in the C.J. Rayburn race cars, Rayburn-powered Lightning house car. And along with him, 15 years since he's been in an open wheel modified, the Cordell Fabrication Tony Nichols Shaw race car out of Crossville, Tennessee. The 11 car is Kenny Cordell. Kenny Cordell, lap one. Donnie Adams to second fast to 16.187. 16.187, the Lightning House car powers down the back straightaway. The 11 car of Kenny Cordell, 17.545. Can Donnie get it done? Slows down on lap two. Donnie Adams will stay second fast to 16.187. And Kenny Cordell improves to 17.394 in that Shaw race car. First time he's had it on the racetrack this year. As we go to the next two, it'll be the J1 car to Newport, Tennessee. Morristown Dental Lab, Monterey's of Newport, James Power Warrior race car for Terry James. And looks like he'll be the final qualifier. Cody Adams not going to make the call for qualifying, so lap one for Terry James. In the J1 at 17.808, 17.808, having some problems over in one and two. Now gets it down the back straightaway. And going to loop it in turn number three. So Terry James gets into the wall after looping over in turn number three. Little bit of damage on the front end of the car. 20 cars set to get it done here tonight as they fill in to the most famous formation down the back straightaway. Everybody up on your feet, ladies and gentlemen. As they get ready to head to the front straightaway, one of the greatest sights that you'll ever see in dirt racing. They are the action-packed quadruple stacked Bruce Built Performance Iron Man Modifieds. They will roll to you down the front straightaway. Ladies and gentlemen, they are four wide. Make some noise for the Bruce Built Performance Iron Man Modifieds. Oh, what a beautiful sight to see as they roll past the flag stand four wide. Here tonight at 411, 20 of the greatest stars and cars of the Bruce Built Performance Ironman Modifieds ready to do battle for 25 laps. Duking it out for that $1,200 top prize, waving them off down the back straight away. As they roll by their pit crews over in the hot pit, saluting them and sending them off. Yeah, they will break formation over in turn number three. We'll put a little heat in the tires. So everybody gets a little heat in the tires. Looks like Kenny Cordell has looped down in turn number four. We'll get him turned back around, rejoin the field. And we should be ready to go for the 25-lap feature. Sean Flannery set to start on the pole for tonight's 25-lap feature, looking to capture on the absence of point leader Blake Brown here tonight. Sean in second in the points. And if he has a good night, could close himself well within reach of Blake Brown for the final four events of the season. And the finale for the Bruce Built Performance Ironman Modifieds will be right here at 411. That will be on November the 25th at the Leftover. Details to come for that event, but we will see these guys back for another 1,200 to win, 25-lap feature, and that will close out the point season for the Bruce Built Performance Ironman Modifieds. So this will be a precursor to what we're going to see at the Leftover, but certainly a stout field of cars that see the one to go signal at the line, and when we turn them loose out of turn number four next time by, they're gonna duke it out for a big $1,200 to win check. We'll get a word with the winner on the front straightaway when we are concluded, but we've got 25 long laps to get there. It's Sean Flannery, it's Donnie Adams, it's showtime, here we go. Flannery with the lead down into turn number one. Donnie Adams works the top. Here comes Clayton Miller. Down the back straightaway. Caution is out. And I don't believe series director Chris Tilley did not like that start. Just a little bit too quick for Sean Flannery. So we'll try it again. The Mount Carmel missile, Sean Flannery, and Mr. Lightning, Donnie Adams, on the front row with two proven champions back in row two, Clayton Miller and Chase King. Out of four, better start, here we go. Donnie to the outside as they get down into turn number one. He'll slide up to the cushion, down the back straightaway, here we go. Sean Flannery side by side with Donnie Adams, and Adams rockets to the lead in turn number three. Side by side out of turn number four, they come to the line. Mr. Lightning bolts past Sean Flannery to lead lap one. Clayton Miller working the bottom over in turn number one and two. They're nearly three wide for the lead down the back straightaway. Here comes Elkton, Kentucky's Clayton Miller. Side by side for second with Flannery down in turn number three and four. Flannery up off the top. Slides all the way to the wall out of turn number four, and Donnie Adams still leads down the back straightaway. Chase King running in fourth. Melbourne, Kentucky, Jody Puckett out in the third spot. Then it's Justin Blevins in 6th and 50. 29 of Joey Cotterman is 7th, up 3 spots from the restart. And we got trouble over in turn number 1 and 2. It is the 2 car of Cody Adams who goes around over in turn number 1 and 2, and he'll draw the yellow. Donnie Adams with 2 wins on the year. The last one came about 3 weeks ago at the Gap, but the biggest one would be here tonight. If he can pull it off, Cody Adams goes to the infield with an overheating number 2. We bring him back to green out of turn number 4. And quickly, Sean Flannery going to throw the slider down in turn number 1. Here comes Adams around the top. Flannery couldn't get there. Donnie still in the lead. 15 car of Clayton Miller starting to close in on the top 2. Now look at the battle for 4th between Jody Puckett and the 7 of Chase King. Clayton Miller back to the bottom, down in turn number 1 and 2. They'll battle side by side down the back straightaway. Flannery pulls out in 2nd. Side by side for 4th, there comes Jody Puckett. And now Flannery slides up to the turn 4 while Donnie Adams holding him off for the meantime. 4 laps in the books. And now Flannery tries it again down in turn number 1 and 2. Good racing for the lead. Flannery likes those slide jobs out of the corners. Still can't get there in turn number 3. It's still Donnie Adams in the Lightning House car. Flannery back to the bottom in 1. Starting to pull away the top 2. Pulling some distance on Clayton Miller down the back straightaway as the battle for 4 still rages on. Jody Puckett and Chase King still side by side for that spot. As they come out of turn number 4, King will hold the spot in the Scotty Evans Motorsports number 7. Good racing all through the field. Cotterman has made it from 10th to 6th and 29, so he's racing towards the top 5. As Donnie Adams starting to catch lap traffic, we got cars getting together in turn number 1 and 2. Crane got sideways, Mosley collected, and we stay green. I believe Mosley actually saved Chad Crane from spinning the car, and it may have broken something on the 11 of Jamie Mosley as he is off the pace down in turn number 1. Continuing to work through lap cars now, Donnie Adams around the top side of the speedway, Sean Flannery right with him. As they get to Terry James' problems, it's Billy Palmer in turn 2, and Donnie Adams is in the wall. Billy Palmer spun over in turn number 2. The field got bottled up, and Donnie Adams slapped the wall in turn number 2. And we'll have to see if anything is broken on the 90 car. Tough break for your leader, Donnie Adams. 8 laps in the book, 17 to go. Mini Stocks, we need you in staging, gentlemen. Mini Stocks to staging for your feature. We'll see if Donnie Adams can hold on after getting into the wall right as the caution come out. Green is back out. We're underway. And Sean Flannery quickly back towards the lead down in turn number 1. And he may have the run down the back straightaway. Here comes Donnie for the lead. Donnie Adams and Sean Flannery going at it for the lead here tonight at 4:11. Slap job out of turn 4. Flannery to the lead. Donnie now will slide up the hill in turn number 1, but Sean Flannery has made it to the lead as they hit down the back straightaway. Donnie Adams holds down 2nd. Gotta wonder if something may be a little amiss on the 90 car after getting into the wall when the yellow came out. Clayton Miller 3rd, and now here comes Jody Puckett, and he's got 4th away from Chase King. Down the back stretch they go. Donnie Adams trying to run down the 98 of Sean Flannery. As Jamie Mosley is off the pace down in turn number 1. Clayton Miller digging hard off the bottom of turn number 2, trying to run down your leaders. Everyone down the back straightaway. Puckett has made it to 4th, and it's a gaggle of cars from there on back. Here comes Joey Cotterman into the top 5 from 10th. running around the bottom of the racetrack. He's got fifth. He may be having fourth down the back straightaway. Here he comes to the inside of Jody Puckett. Halfway now. 13 laps in the books, 12 to go for Sean Flannery out front leading. Looking for a $1,300 payday. After setting fast time, claiming that $100 bonus. And he's out front leading as the caution comes out. Caution is out. Coming out, debris on the racetrack. Slows us down on lap number 14. 25-lap Bruce Built Performance Ironman Modified Show. Much like the one you've seen here tonight, it's been a good show so far. We're just halfway, 13 in the books, 12 to go. And the Mount Carmel missile will bring us back to green out of turn number 4. We're back underway. Racing down into turn number 1. Sean Flannery going to slide up the hill. And Donnie Adams with a big run down the back straightaway. Clayton Miller running in second. Problems in turn 2. And the 11 car goes around over in turn number 2. Cotterman, Joey Cotterman out of Cookeville, Tennessee, has made it up to the 6th spot. Jimmy Dalton is 7th. 8th is the 50 of Justin Blevins. Amos Bunch in the 59th. And Zach Powers rounds out the top 10 as we bring them back to green. Here we go. Flannery spun the tires just a little bit on the start. He goes back to the bottom in 1. Here comes Donnie off the top. Down the back straightaway. He'll rock it down the backside. Trying to run down Sean Flannery. Cost him about 2 car lengths that time. Flannery back to the top down in turn number 3. And he'll continue to lead. Cotterman trying to work over Chase King as they get back into turn number 1. Everybody heads down the back straightaway. It is still Sean Flannery out front leading. In the 98 car over Donnie Adams. Third runs the 15 of Clayton Miller. Yes, now Flannery has went to the top side down in turn number 1 and 2, and he rockets down the back straightaway, opening up a huge lead over Donnie Adams as they exit turn number 4. In the final 10 circuits now, it'll be 8 to go when they get back to the line. Someone is off the pace. That is the 271 of Chad Crane down the front straightaway. And it's going to be interesting to see if Sean Flannery gets back into that heavy lap traffic that leads into turn number 3 and 4 right now. It could definitely change the perplexion of this event here in the closing laps. A lot of good racing in the back of the pack with 18 laps now down, 7 laps to go. Sean Flannery, a couple of wins here on the year, downscaling his program. This year used to have a big old toter home, toured quite a bit around the Eastern U.S., going to several events. And scaled down his program, told me a few weeks ago he wanted to start running more local events, especially with the Open Wheel Modifieds trying to make a comeback in East Tennessee. Spent a while in the super late model ranks, ran a tenure there for a couple of years, had a couple of wins in the super late model, went back to the modifieds, and has had nothing but success since he climbed back behind the wheel and looking to add a $1,200 payday to it here tonight as he leads down the back straightaway. It'll be 2 to go this time at the line. He has caught into that lap traffic. He's got by Dustin Dyden. Now Billy Palmer will be next with 2 laps to go, but he's got a huge lead over Donnie Adams. As they get back into 1, he goes back to the bottom, trying to get around Steve Clark. And when they exit turn number 3 this time and out of 4, Sean Flannery will see the white flag. Excuse me, now it's 2 to go. 2 to go now, so they'll see the white flag the next time by. Gets hung up a little bit on the lap car out of turn number 4. White flag now in the air for Sean Flannery. Final time around. Big lead over Donnie Adams. out of turn number two, down the back straightaway. Donnie had a good run here tonight, led several laps, but he got bit by the Mount Carmel missile. Sean Flannery will go to victory lane. Second will go to Donnie Adams. Third at the line will be Clayton Miller. Fourth will go to Puckett, and fifth to Chase King. That with this win, Sean Flannery now the new points leader with four events left. 4 points will be the lead heading into the final events of the season as he unstraps, gets ready to climb out of the race car. And here he comes. How about it for the Mount Carmel missile? Sean Flannery! Man, that looks so fun. I want to go get an open wheel. I'll tell you what, great battle with Donnie. You've been hooked up pretty much everywhere you've went this year. This MB Customs has been really good for you.
Yeah, Jimmy Mars built me a really good race car. You know, Donnie Adams is a very veteran driver. I feel very fortunate to beat him tonight. I mean, I remember the first time I ever beat him was at Mountain Motor Speedway. I was more excited than I think if I'd won the World 100. I mean, he's just a really good driver and really hard to beat.
Been racing with him for a long time. Of course, the caution came over and he got into the wall just a little bit, looked like. But you pulled an incredible move on the restart, slid her down into turn number one, way up the hill in two, and got around him. It's just an incredible race.
Yeah, I knew I had to do something around on the start. The track was wonderful tonight. I mean, it was good and slick. You can't ask for a better track. I mean, we hadn't come here until last year. I kicked myself for not coming before that. I mean, everybody kept telling me what a great place this was. I mean, the McCarter family, they've done a great job here. They do a good job at Bulls Gap, too, so y'all need to go up there, too. I mean, we're really appreciative of them running open-wheel modifieds. I mean, we hope that they continue to do it. I think we put on a pretty good show here tonight, and hopefully we didn't have too many cautions, but I hope the McCarters keep running us. It really makes me happy to come here.
We talked a little while ago about your tenure. You had a tenure short, a couple of years in the super late model ranks, and talk about how that helped you. You went to super late models, ran a couple of years, won a race or two, and then come back to the modifieds. And man, you were good in the supers, but man, you come back to these modifieds, you really dominated. You've had a lot of good performances.
Yeah, I really think that the late model hurt me with my modified because I think a lot of racing really is built off of momentum, and we lost a lot of momentum when we went to the late model. We had it rolling pretty good before that with our modified. When we came back, we were kind of behind. You know, we 2 years away from something, you think, well, that's not too much. But we got behind, and we didn't have our momentum going again. So I think hopefully we got our momentum back. Maybe we'll start wins, clicking off a few more wins this year. I think we got 4 more wins, and we'll get to 100 career victories this year.
Look good tonight, and with this win tonight, 4 points. Now you've taken over the points lead for the Ironman Mods. That's got to be good momentum going into the final events.
Yeah, I knew we had to finish top two tonight to take the lead in the points. So really wanted to win, but, you know, we wanted to finish this race too. We had a little bad luck up there at Tazewell last week and didn't have a good finish at all, so that hurt us. We was hoping to replace one of our bad runs there. But, you know, we come in here tonight. We've been running good here. I knew they was going to get some good cars, but just hoping for a top two, maybe top three there just to keep the points interesting. But to take the win here and take the lead in the points, we're really happy.
Looking forward to seeing you back at the leftover. How about it? New point leader, Sean Flannery. Now we're going to come over and get a word with this young man. Donnie, I'll tell you what. You guys really put on a show. I know that had to probably hurt the car just a little bit, got in the wall over there when the caution came out. But this Lightning House car was pretty good tonight.
Yeah, it was all right. I was hoping that Sean would just have the points lead by one if I'd have won this race, but that lap car sort of dictated that. I don't know. Sean was awful good, and I had the line. I didn't know if I'd be able to hold him off or not anyway, and then that lap car hit me in the door and knocked me up on the wall, and I was afraid I was done then. It's knocked out. Toes probably knocked out 3 inches, it looks like. I suppose the A-arms is bent and everything else, but I was lucky to hang on for second.
Still had a good performance here tonight. Got a late start in the season we talked about. Got a couple of wins on the year and won the last event we had at the Gap up there. And these Lightning House cars, man, they've been pretty good. Your brother David ran last week at Tazewell and had a nice top five. But these things are looking really good right now.
Yeah, we've been working hard on them. I bought some data acquisition and a pull-down rig and we've learned a lot of stuff here in the last year, and this car of mine's a a one-of-a-kind car, and it's an old swing arm car that we've done a little different stuff to, and that thing is pretty good everywhere we've been so far. Now, Jared that helps me, he's building himself one. He'll be out here in 2 or 3 weeks, and then there'll be two of them, and maybe we'll learn a little faster, but they're okay like they are.
Good run tonight to hold on to second. How about it? Give him a big round of applause. Mr. Lightning, Donnie Adams.